May I get everyone to please stand as the family joins us this afternoon? Brian, can I get a little more mic? Thank you. I want to thank you all for coming out this afternoon for the service of Miss Laverne Brickhouse. And I know the family is very grateful for you coming. I know you are as well, especially as many of you are friends or basically family, no matter what. So allow us to open up with prayer this afternoon. Let us pray. Father, we're so grateful for your love. We're so grateful for your mercy. We're so grateful that you've had a plan for us throughout this time as we live on this earth that is only temporary. But we're also so grateful for Miss Laverne Brickhouse as she lived her life to the fullest of 90-some years old. And she had lived it through the end, dedicated not only to you, to the church, but also to her family, her friends, and to her job, and everything else that she had done. But also pray that you be with the family today as we know that Miss Laverne is not with us today and that we know that she does live in our hearts and our minds and that we will never forget what she had left behind for us to continue for her. And it's in your son's name we pray. Amen. I have a couple of scriptures of comfort I'd like to share with you this afternoon. First one comes from John 11, 25 through 26. He said, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? And in Matthew 5, verses 3 and 4, he says, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. But I also want to carry you back to the Psalms again here. Psalm 23. He says, The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in front of the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Miss Laverne Brickhouse, born April 29, 1930. Gone to her eternal home, June 17, 2024. Miss Laverne Baum Brickhouse, age 94, of Poplar Branch, North Carolina, passed away on June 17, 2024 at the Commonwealth Senior Living Georgian Manor in Chesapeake, Virginia. She was born on April 29, 1930 to the late Warney Earl Baum and S.C. Victoria Spence Baum. Laverne was a postmaster with the United States Postal Service for over 30 years. Her passion for line dancing and playing bridge brought a joy to her life outside of work. She was a longtime member of Sharon Methodist Church in the Poplar Branch, North Carolina, where she faithfully served as the Sunday school secretary and valued member of the choir. And Miss Laverne was also involved in the Order of the Eastern Star, Chapter 218, Koyunjuk, North Carolina, while it existed. Miss Laverne is reunited in heaven with her parents, her beloved husband of 75 years. That's a long time. Ernest John Brickhouse, and I know he is happy that she is home with him today. Her sisters Joyce O'Neill, Dorcas Taylor, and Willard Tucker, and her brothers Junior Baum and Johnny Baum. I'm going to skip down to the next part here. Laverne will be remembered for her dedication to her family, her community, her faith, and she will be deeply missed by all who knew and loved her and still know her today. We will now have our song. I had talked to the family a little bit the other day about Miss Laverne and got to learn a little bit about her, and she seemed to be a pretty amazing woman. And I know her husband knew he had a great woman as long as they were married and were together. But her faith was important to her. Her faith was very important to her because it had shown throughout her life that she was devoted to her friends and family in the community. Her generosity had shown throughout everything she had done. And she was a very simple woman, not being any way out like showy kind of thing, but she just did what she could to make people happy and what she had done. She loved her family especially. She loved her community, and I'll get to that part in a minute here. She loved her church. She loved being a part of the church. She loved enjoying to doing the different things in the church. She was a hard worker. I got to hear that she was the postmaster at the mail place. And they were sharing a story with me about duck stamps. She would take duck stamps home on the weekend so that the hunters could come and buy them if somebody needed them, if they took a group out or if they didn't have theirs. So they would come and show up at her door 3, 5 o'clock in the morning to buy duck stamps so they could go hunting. Now that's a dedicated postmaster right there. She took her job home with her, but she loved doing it. She loved sharing with her community. She loved her family dearly. And I didn't get a chance to know her at all, but I will tell you, at her age, she looks really good. She looks really good. And one of the guys that asked me, he goes, "How old is she?" I said, "She's in her 90s. He goes and reads and looks, and comes back to me and says, "She's 94. There ain't no way." I said, "I know, but she looks good." She was getting ready to be with her husband. She wanted to make sure she looked good for him, too. But the interesting part is she did everything and anything she could to help anybody, especially in the church when she did that. And I know the Red Hats ladies had fun. I got to see that picture. And I usually see y'all out at times when y'all have your lunches or dinners, and y'all seem to have a really good time. But I know she'll be missed. I know her presence will be missed. But her presence doesn't have to be physical with us. Like I said in my prayer, she lives in our hearts and minds, and nobody can take that from us. But also, with my message here this afternoon, it's entitled, "You Can't Bury Influence." And it says, some people come into our lives and quickly go. Others stay for a while and leave footprints on our hearts and that we can never erase. We are never the same as we know after we lose somebody, but we still live the same way. Now, as we think about that, she lived her life dedicated to everyone else, to her family, to her friends. And she did that so much that her influence built up to the point that people knew they could rely on her. People knew that they could go to her, especially the hunters at 3 o'clock in the morning who wanted to go duck hunting or had a group that wanted to go. They made sure they had their duck stamps. But that's the best part about her is she was a great influence to others around her. But we look at this, and we look at God himself who had given us the great gift. And that's the gift that God has given us is his son who died on the cross for our sins. He gave us somebody, as we look back in the Old Testament, they always talked about there's that one that is coming who's going to bring us home. There's that one who's going to clear us of all of our sins. And I believe Miss Laverne had that faith and knew that she was going to a home, her eternal home. And she did everything she could to live her life to the fullest, to the T, and to dot in every I as she lived, as she worked for her job as a postmaster, as she went to church daily, as she had taken care of her family. She lived her life to the fullest. And we can look back at John 3:16, and he says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." We have a Father who gave his Son up for us so that we can have an eternal home. Miss Laverne gave up some of her sleep hours at times so that she could make sure some of the guys could duck hunt. Or she gave up her time for church to make sure that others were taken care of. But also she spent time with her friends in the church or family, which I believe when you attend a church, you're not just friends, you're family. And she created a family that she wanted to be with at all the time. And she did that. But as we look at Miss Laverne's works were many and will long be remembered as we know it. The book of Hebrews goes back and tells us this. He says, "He being dead yet speaketh, you cannot bury influence." The same influence you cannot bury where God had said, "I give my son to die on the cross for you and our sins, for your sins, because I created a home, an eternal home for you, so that we wouldn't perish." And this influence, though, also combines here with the influence, it is not reflected in a mirror. The influence is not defined by a demonstration. Her influence is not calculated by mathematics, nor is God's. Influence is not dissected by logic. But influence is not measured by a surveyor's chain. And influence is not weighed on scales. As we look at both of their influences, as Miss Laverne had influenced us or influenced you all here today, and as God has influenced your life as well, we see the match. We see the path that she had taken was the same that she was given. And she chose to live a life for God, to give it to him. But also, influence is the total effect of one's life upon another. Much of a life cannot be put in the grave. Let me give you a couple examples here. Alexander Graham Bell is in the grave, but the telephone continues to ring. Now we got these new iPhones or Galaxy things, you know, all these different things that we can contact each other, but they never stop ringing, do they? Sometimes we wish they would. But Edison is in the grave, but the electric light shines. It keeps shining on. The only time it doesn't stop shining, or it stops shining, is when we don't pay our bill. But F.B. Morrison is in the grave, but the telegraph ticks on. Miss Laverne has been called away, but her influence can never be erased. And somewhere out there in a place we call eternity, someone will probably say this: "Thank you, Miss Laverne. You made a difference in my life." Many, many adults, children in the years to come will be indeed indebted to her, or may have learned something from her that she may have taught them. And it's kind of like you remember things when somebody's taught you something, or when a parent says something to you, and you kind of look at, you know, and I do this a lot, because I remember my parents used to tell me a whole bunch of stuff, and I never listened. And I grew up in the church. Of course, I think it was because I hung out with the elders' kids. But that's, you know, not here nor there, or the deacon's kids, but my dad was a deacon. But the thing is this. The parents in the church always looked after all of us, and we had one parent tell us, you know, that's going to catch up with you one day. And they were talking about us messing around, doing things or whatever we shouldn't have been doing. Years later, it rings in your head, and you're like, ooh, somebody told me that. And that's the same thing. Miss Laverne probably shared something with somebody or said, you know, you got this, even when things were hard. And said, you got this. You can live on. Because today is not the time that we say goodbye to Miss Laverne. Today is the day that we say, I'll see you later. I'll see you in our heavenly home, our eternal home. Because that's where God wants us to be. And we could take Miss Laverne's influence and love and what she had shared with us or with you all here, and just say, you know, she's right. If she can live a life to 94, that's amazing. but still continue to do what she can to help those. And I know there may have been times that she couldn't, but I bet in you she never forgot to pray for you all. Allow me to close in prayer. Father, as we come in prayer with you again, we just ask that you be with this wonderful family. We ask that you be with these wonderful friends. As I say, they are family because you call us to be a family. But I pray that you be with them throughout this time, as Miss Laverne is not with us physically, but she does live in our hearts and minds. And there's going to be things that she said or shared that are going to ring in our head continually. We may get a giggle out of it. We may get a tear or few or more. But the best part is we know that she is home with you and with her husband. And we know that she is looking down on us today. And that she's always going to make sure and check in every now and then, even though she physically can't talk to us, but we know that she's going to be thinking of us. But I just pray that you be with this wonderful family as they go to their separate homes and their separate places. But also pray that you be with the church as they come together as a group again and to worship with each other, that you be with them and that they share in prayer, just like that Miss Laverne is right there with them, sharing in prayer with them. Because we pray to continually strive to look up to you and to strive to finish this race in the way that you want us to, so that we can reach the goal that you have given us, and that is our eternal home. And it's in your sons that we pray. Amen.